A kid from Cornwall, land of beauty, but often lacking in opportunity, dreamed of a world far bigger than his own, bigger than the place he'd already outgrown. In local theatre, he took the first plunge, listening and learning soaked it up like a sponge. Trips to Theatre Royal Plymouth, the pavilions too, plays, pantos and musicals to name but a few. Discounts and concessions opened new doors to many that hadn't seen live theatre before. The Connections Festival, performing at the Drum, making friends and having so much fun. This kid moved to London, trained hard for 3 years, got a job, some experience and blood, sweat and tears. Took weird and wacky jobs just to get by. Some days he'd laugh, others he'd cry. This profession is unlike any other, but no matter the hardship, we look out for each other. Our stories may be similar or so far apart, but we all share a love that comes straight from the heart. We know we're not key workers or saving lives, but the arts is something that has to survive. For when a new normal begins and we all raise a toast, we want to be back when you need us the most. Venues are closing, but what can be done? Do not forget the place you came from, for those helped you get to where you are now. But new danger beckons, they're shouting for help out loud. The government must act, listen to the outcry, as the industry vanishes before our very eyes. For this ain't just about London, it's far bigger, you see, affecting each and every community. When I was at school, there were 3 drama teachers. There's now 1. With funding cuts in education, damage has already been done. But it's not academic, it doesn't make the grade, but with it, lives have often been changed. The chance to express who you really are, teamwork, new skills, and to shine like a star. It's not just for those who want it as a career. It builds confidence, gives a voice to those we might not always hear. Put down your books. Music, TV and sky, I wonder how long you could really survive. Art in all its forms has always been here, one of the only things that survived through the years. But now this virus puts us on the brink, but it won't be the arts that just starts to sink. Restaurants, cafes, bars, all businesses that rely aplenty on an audience's custom and those 3-course meals for 20. When the future looks bleak, it's hard to imagine a time where theatres are lit up and we're all dressed up to the nines. On stage, off, front of house, we all work as one. A night well remembered is a job that's well done. Self-employed grants in money they lack, and those with no history just fall down the crack. Those new grads who've worked as hard as the rest are now facing the world's biggest test. We can get other jobs. For that, we're not worried. For theatre as we know it won't be back in a hurry. But pause for a moment. And remember a time where a song, show or book affected your life. Why these words, you may ask? Well, I really don't know. It just kept me busy and from feeling so low. Now thank you for listening. If you got this far, keep fighting, keep vocal, keep positive, and let's save the arts. Check up on your friends. Make sure they're okay. A message of love goes a very long way. Questions are still unanswered, but I hope it's not long until the curtain rises, as the show will go on.